Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in to today's sick video. Doing Jeremy Friday for today's sick video. So as always on a Friday, we're having a look at the weather for the month ahead with the Japanese and CFS meeting models, and I shall get on with that for you in a moment. Just to say that first video today was 6 a.m. upload. We've got 10 to 14 day coming to you later this afternoon, and then this evening around 7 o'clock, we're gonna have the ECMWF for 2 day slash 6 weeks weekend. And if that wasn't enough, you'll be live streaming one last time at 10:30. So for the final time this season, we're going to have the Friday night live stream. So I shall see you late tonight, maybe, if you're around the channel. So it's a busy day of content today, one of Gav's crazy days where we're like a conveyor belt to churning out all of the videos and streams and whatnot. But if you enjoy the content on the channel at the moment, then please do you like, share, subscribe. Thank you so very much, everybody, for doing that. Drop a comment and let us know what you think about this and all of our videos. We do thank you very, very much for doing that. Okay, let's get on with Jeremy Friday then. So I'm going to start off with the week one 500 millibar height anomaly from the Arctic North Pole view down. So this is the North Pole just here, the wider Arctic Circle around there. And of course, got the latitudes through there. So blue is extrapolating to below average heights, which is low pressure. Yellow, orange, and red to above average heights, which is high pressure. So breaking down into week periods. The first week period will take us from today, the 24th, through to the 31st of March, last day of the month. The next week, the coming week, or week we're just starting, will be unsettled with low pressure in off the Atlantic into northern and western Europe, combined with high pressure down towards Spain. We've got wind in from the west, so an unsettled week one starts off. Week two will be the 31st of March to the 7th of April, again with below average heights, low pressure in off the Atlantic, higher pressure down towards Spain, Portugal, and winds again remaining in from a westerly direction. So once more, the unsettled weather continues. Now we see a change when we get through the week three and four. This is the 7th to the 21st of April. Above average heights, high pressure starts appearing then around Greenland and Iceland again, with below pressure being sent off to the south and being blocked out to west. That could well turn the wind into the east. It will certainly be turning drier there, I think, with those easy winds. The actual temperature would depend on the exact origin of the east. If the east is north of the east from up here, then it could actually still be really quite cold. If the origin is like south of east, some mist sort of area, then that could be a relatively mild wind direction in April. So 50-50 as to what the temperatures will be doing. But it will certainly be drying things out anyway as we progress on into April. Right, let's have a look at tropical and mid latitude view next. So we can't see Greenland, Iceland, Scandinavia, the Arctic, North Pole, all those areas off the chart up here. We've had a look at that view down though, so we know what's going on. Reminder of the week one 500 millibar height only for the UK and Ireland just here, showing low pressure again coming in from off the Atlantic. So we're expecting a relatively cool week further north, a little bit milder further south though, and but not particularly big deviation, so temperatures aren't that exciting, and a wet week as well. So yes, we're gonna have a wet final week to what has been an unsettled March with above average rainfall. Week two is the 31st of March to the 7th of April. Low pressure below average height still coming in from off the Atlantic. Temperatures again about average, a little bit below maybe for the far north of the country, slightly above in the south, not a particularly big deviation. And still looking unsettled again for the beginning of April. That first week coming out wetter than average. And then week three and four show that change, and if you envisage that like Iceland and Greenland and that would be just here, Scandinavia would be over there. So we've got high pressure to our north and winds coming in from like an easterly direction potentially then. The temperature anomaly is about average once more, perhaps ever so slightly above, not seeing anything that cold. And precipitation wise, it looks like it's a bit wetter for the south and drier to the north actually. So southern areas still have an influence from lower pressure, northern areas close to that blocking area of high pressure drying out. Right, so that's the JMA. Let's have a look at Surface V2 and see how that compares. Again, means our 500 millibar height anomaly is breaking down into weak periods. The first weak period takes from 24 of March to the 30th. Again, we've got the low pressure in off the Atlantic through to northern and western parts of Europe. Week 2 is going to be the 31st March to the 6th of April. Just a little bit more influence from high pressure close to Spain there. So that could be turning things a little bit milder, maybe, with winds from the southwest. Although we're not that far from still having like a northwesterly. And you will notice we have got a fair amount of northern blocking as well there from Greenland to Svalbard. Right, okay, so week 3 is going to be the 7th to the 13th of April. Now look at this, we get a mid-Atlantic ridge. It goes up to Greenland and extends out to the north of Scandinavia to Svalbard and Svalbard with below average heights across Western Europe. And that would have wind in from potentially quite a cold northeasterly direction. That's over the Easter period as well. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear, a cold Easter maybe. And then week 4 is the 14th to the 20th of April. The high pressure more towards Scandinavia, and that's probably bringing the wind more south of east. So I reckon that'll see a recovery in the temperature. But one thing that would be going on here is that it would be drying out as we're going through April, so it wouldn't be anywhere near as unsettled as it has been during March. Right, temperature anomaly for week 1, 24th March 30th, is about average, a little bit below for Scotland, maybe. Week 2 is milder, so we bring up those southwesterly winds in week 2, 31st March, 6th April, and the temperature goes above average. Actually, it does look very cold over on the eastern side of Europe and across Scandinavia, though, really cold then. And then week 3 is going to be the 7th of April to the 13th, temperature's lower, back close to average. Most parts of Europe looking quite cold there. I reckon that could be a colder week, actually, in week 3. And then week 4 is the 14th to the 20th of April, possibly showing a bit of a recovery in the temperature. So temperatures continue to be a bit up and down. Precipitation-wise, week 1 is going to be wetter than average, especially more western areas, 24th to 30th of March. Week 2, not as wet, but still above average rainfall in northern areas. Week 3 is losing a signal, as it always does, but will probably be drying out. And then week 4, again, no particular signal. But I reckon it's probably trending drier as we're going through April. Right, okay, so got relatively good agreement between the two models today. We're starting off unsettled for the final week of March. We'll have further low pressure ring spells of rain that probably lasting into early April. Looks like there could be cold snap setting up sometime from the first week to the second week of April. How cold that gets, how far we go a bit, that remains to be seen. It's quite a way off, but there is a hint between both of those bars and some northern blocking them as we get into the second week of April. Beyond that, we're just going to have to wait and see. Right, okay, that was just a snapshot of what these two models are showing today. They could look completely different when we look at them again next week. Any forecast beyond 5-7 days comes with big hail warnings and large pinches of salt attached. You'll find out this evening whether the ECMWF extended 6 weeks forecast agrees with JMA Friday today. So that'll be interesting to see, and that'll be coming up at 7 p.m. this evening. Before then, we're going to have your 10 to 14 there, so I shall see you a little bit later on for that one. But for JMA Friday for this week, that's all for now, and thanks for watching.